space really is playing a big part in the talking about the
situation.
I think I'm not, there's not really a space to be there with you. I think more of this lives in the space. So the idea that I had after our conversation was sort of this.
Checking it out.
Okay. It looks cool.
I only recently got it and I just wanted to see what kind of a shot it would be.
Make you discomfort.
in these like very
lovely, it's a lovely synesthetic experience. I'm able to get a little bit of a feeling of how it can be.
It might be interesting to see how these things become.
I agree with you, Bob. I agree. I think that it's not too much.
Not too much.
It was great. It was just in the mirror, and any simple friend didn't know where it was coming from. But I think she was wearing was that the costume that Mark wore? Obviously. But it was very casual. I mean, there wasn't. I like the way it was sitting.
It's really interesting. It's nice to know that that's what it is. Also, to be how that's going to feel to do that. But it's like these flashes, small,
I kind of like
as opposed to some long.
It's unexpected. People don't expect something.
You know, it's like you sort of flashes.
The lights of those two, of course.
In the mount of Morelos in Mexico, I've heard it said that if you're struck by lightning, you will die if you do not find a healer whose power comes from being hit by lightning. And then you will become a healer, charged with that lightning. Was Nietzsche? This fusion is truly an inspiring.
What was the world like before the sun?
In that time, human beings lived in a continuous twilight, and there was essentially no human speaking people, animals, and things. And you know all animals and things. The enemy, the condors, mountain lions, jaguars, snakes, seabirds, large stone outcrops, petroglyphs, and small stone cans. Which I'm telling you, I'm here, right? The room is about a piece of room. Some people say that before the sun came into existence, the world was illuminated by fireflies. For the moment, we have weathered the storm. We have come through the other side, but it's no longer like it once was, because now we float in dreamlands of rain and sunshine. And I took note of the following. That we run on automatic pilot, which involves the body of the world.
There are moments in the music where, like, I'm being kind of playful, even at times, where, like, he's talking about, like, this really intense experience, and I'm playing, like, you were my sunshine. It's like, there was, like, this girl, this the mouth of meth that she was naked, and I'm like,
yes, it's very clear in the program. This is not a theater. It's not a performance. It's a theater piece edging into the ritual. So it has that heavy feeling, contrasting the you were my sunshine.
So that you stop and we watch Kyle and her hand, so that you know they're really not only coming, but they become, you know, but that art form is also being. And there are parts actually, I think when I was that I put down, he should be dancing more, she can't dance more dance.
Big rectangular space. Nick and Annie are slightly in the corner, so it's slightly to the.
It's,
our idea was from the corner out. And then the audience of, like, say, Nick is sitting over there, and the audience is in sort of concentric half circles going back.
And also let us transition to sort of bridge the acts. So maybe we do really want to explore the idea of
the dance. Yeah, you just can't do that. It's one light. It's one lighting that you never get created.
It's a dance.
It's daylight, sunlight, what would God have to do? So the very next step for us is, okay, so then how do we wind up reinterpreting that, both to support the piece and in the space?
Attuned to blinding light, the solar rings, the rotten sun, the burning sun, the crude breath sun, the dragon sun, which annuls every will, keeping all things in servile immobility, cradled in violence, as arbitrary as dreams. What did we do when we unchained the earth with its sun? Whither are we moving now?
All the gestures, like hips down, and we're not going to be able to see that. So you'll have to do the arm gestures more.
I think I'll do the second part.
Yeah.
Also, like whenever you do dance and follow-up, Smoke a cigarette.
I like that.
Like very didactic to it. Nobody would say that on the film. Does that make sense at all? As in, to give that same message, but in speech-like, a speech-like language, maybe. As if you're actually saying it to someone on the phone, not reading it on the paper.
No way that we
sometimes that band stops, but that's with a black of gravel, then it just continues for a while. I just want the next section uninterrupted.
That's wonderful. That's a great image. That's a great image also for that sound.
Further over.
I shortened Act 3 a little and tried to make it clear, so I want you guys to listen. Peter's running around all the time. But I'm curious. Maybe Kieran Ferreira could share one.
Should I have it?
Did you
share something? I have it on my computer.
I sent it to you.
Didn't you?
Yeah, I think so. It's called 23 or 24 or something.
I sent it today.
You have
24? Yeah, I have
23.
Oh, wait, is it
24? Yeah, but I think 24 is basically the same as 23. It's like Detroit, but I mean, Model E. Everywhere, that's all.
I'm just thinking that at some point we should just make a decision about at when is it for each act, a few minutes at the beginning of each act.
Oh, right,
just
right,
when the cues
important.
Are, and
yeah.
Then Peter can run the cues, like physically,
yeah.
That collaboration.
Yeah, that's fine. I mean,
work.
You can run it, or you know, if you want to send it to us, we can run it. I mean,
it's
all good. You know what I'm saying? Whatever works best for the piece works best.
This is something we have to think about. The animation for like just run for 3 minutes at the end, beginning of each act, or.
I think
more frequently, longer period.
I feel like we'll know when we just see it at the space park.
Yeah, we'll know tomorrow.
It's probably hard to decide now.
Can't decide now.
Yeah.
And did they're putting up the screens now? Or no, tomorrow? The screens will be in place tomorrow.
Should
screens
I
are in place
to
you? Now. Where, for example, where are the projectors going to be?
I think. I'm not 100% certain. Last time we spoke, and they might have changed it because I literally was away up until digital, I think that we were talking about putting them on the balcony, shooting down.
Okay.
They may be on the balcony outside, shooting into the fabric from outside.
Yeah, that'd be lovely, but not too cold. They said tomorrow it's going to be warmer.
I think they like the cold. I think they like the cold a lot.
Me too.
Projectors. I mean, Norwegians, yeah.
We have a performance in here.
Oh, okay.
We're going to be leaving. Okay, cool. Sorry, I didn't want to.
Are you guys meeting this?
Do you need a
right now? People are going to come in, in 5 minutes.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Okay.
Speaking mimetically, you know, getting something parallel, the quote-unquote firefly dance would start, what was the world like before the sun?
Mm-hmm.
Well, doesn't it come in when the music comes in?
When what?
When the music and the strobe comes in, or before that?
I think that entering when, what was the world like before the sun, I think it links nicely to the text, and it also gives you a chance to dance before the music, right? So I think that's a nice...
It's nice if they come in sort of one...
And then the other is
the
like,
other.
It's a bridge. I think that's really nice.
Can I just direct your attention to something? There's a paragraph halfway down which begins, hear the great drama.
On that page?
So what was the world before?
Mm-hmm.
The sun shone, having no alternative but the nothing new. As the rain bends and the sun shines, the little boy so fearless in the end. Well, there is no end. Not like the word think, as when we say the sun sank in the west, whether there be water or not. The most frequently evoked of all sinkings is the sun setting as a blaze of flame on an iridescent sea, like the blacksmith. Is this the same body that silences the lightning as evidenced by a canal tree trunk? Is this our body, the body of the lightning stops for a while? In the mountains and the whales, I've heard it said that I think that's the end of the community. He said, what I'm thinking is you stay just still, and then you'll move, you'll then come into action.
So you guys have got to coordinate with my daughter. I can't push her around too much. You've got to talk to her. She listens to you. She understands.
I think Peter should run the images unless we need Olivia for some part of it.
Well, you're very familiar now.
Yeah.
That's the idea. Is anyone else? You know, it's right at the end, the evening star, the morning star.
As much fire as possible. I support any kind of fire, any sort of pyrotechnics. Yeah.
You don't know.
No, I said
Okay, we'll try tomorrow. And then the fierce of the time that we're going to live.
So I have like practical notes, so I'm going to like pacing notes and things like that. Do you want me to send that to you?
Or tell
you
no, send it. I was going pretty fast at one point, because I wanted the evening, just to get through the evening, but at the beginning I was trying to space it the way I thought it should be, which is slow, and spaces in between.
No, it was the best reading that I had seen of this iteration yet. The way you read it tonight was really great. But things like the raincoat, like the relationship of taking the coat out of the bag and then putting it on, I think that you need to be like a little bit, conscious about what happens tonight, so that you can speak and take it out, but you shouldn't be putting it on your body as well.
There's a whole subtext which I can now develop. It's like they've got the whole universe in the window, that final slide, that amazing image, and you've got the whole universe in that bag. Now that bag has got the whole cosmos in it, really, the sun, everything. So you pull the bag out, and pull the black raincoat out, and that's the storm. The bag comes up again at the beach where the Indian women put in these tiny shells, which are magical by color, by size and shape. I didn't go into that, but you know, I had a feeling you could do an awful lot with that bag. Just such a simple thing.
I have one question, sort of one thing that kind of happened tonight for the first time when you were telling me, this is something else concerning the relationship between you and the dance, but you said you had me sort of stand there and were narrating over my body in a way. And I think that's great. I think there should be more of that kind of relationship, that when I'm dancing, it's as if, you know, I'm in some little music box on your desk. I'm also one of these things, one of these sort of anthropological artifacts that you've brought into this sun theater.
What do you mean, like the bag?
Somehow that, yeah, it's, you know, because there's many things that are pointed to in the piece, and I think the dance should also, I mean, the dance is of itself, but you're also pointing to it in a way. So you shouldn't feel like you have to detach when I'm dancing. I think rather it's, you know, we can be engaged together there. And probably with the music we can do the same as well. We're sort of vibing together. I think that would be, I don't know if that's, that seemed like it was kind of starting, and I would love to develop that more.
Like when you were the world.
Yes. Yes, exactly.
Let's see what we can do.
Yeah,
let me know if there's other places.
Picture Nietzschean in the volcanic mountains of Morelos, Popocatapetl, ash drifting, skyward drifting.
Arrested all these juveniles.
Me? No, I go there twice. I've been there twice this semester. It's at 5 o'clock when there's hardly anyone there. Shouldn't we have the image there? He's dancing in front of the image.
Staring at the setting sun.
A burly man grasps his female companion.
A burly man grasps his female companion in the parking lot. Like statues.
Is this? I'm busy. In the theater. What's it about? I haven't got time. It's about the re-enchantment of nature in the age of global meltdown. But that's right, about reclaiming geosensuality. Take care.
Solemn forms appear to us, approach, and glide away, leaving us in tears. Let us follow Proust on these nightly expeditions through the sleeping body, for this is our sun theater of black ice and blacker gravel. Let us follow Proust on these nightly expeditions as did Walter Benjamin in his voyage into the subterranean city. Architecture, fashion, yes, even the weather.
I like freezing. The sun shone, having no alternative, on the nothing new. The sun shone, having no alternative, on the nothing new.